van Amerika viel dik tegen. Ze kwamen er niet verder dan het voorprogramma van de Cranberries. De verkoop van de tweede cd, Dogman Star, viel ook al tegen. En op de kop toe stapte gitaargenie Bernard Butler op. Maar Suede slaat terug. Haalt de 17-jarige gitarist Richard Oakes van de schoolbanken en zet hem het podium op. Wat gebeurt er nog meer bij Suede op dat podium? Bert Anderson en Simon Gilbert.
Playing most of the set is the new album. We play kind of a few of the old singles and stuff like that, you know. Just to keep all the everyone happy. We play lots of stuff. We play lots of stuff that's yeah, Heron's good off the new album. We play Still Live, things like that. We reinterpret, lots of people ask us, you know, how we play these songs that sound as though they can't be played by four people. We reinterpret them for four people. Yeah, the way we write is very song based, so kind of like the songs work on any sort of instrument almost.
De Britse pers is intussen alweer uitgekeken op Suede en heeft zich op een nog nieuwere hype gegooid, met name Oasis. Wat vinden die van Suede, van al dat gehype achteraf bekeken?
It used to be a kind of a long, sort of slow process. And I think with media playing such a big part now, you know, it's kind of like it really, you can really kind of like explode over a short amount of time. And we exploded quite quickly, but there's bands that sort of post us that have kind of like gone through, you know, an even quicker sort of acceleration.
Third single off the album, and it's got two new B-sides which Richard and Brett wrote together.
It wasn't too much torment, you know. I do really enjoy writing. I actually really enjoy it. I get frustrated when we're on tour all the time because it means time that I can't be writing. It's not creatively stimulating. It's a good laugh. But a lot of things I'm quite a creative person. I want to get in my studio and fiddle around. Lots of ideas, you know. We'll be the